Since you clicked on this video, I honestly think it's safe to say that you have an interest in human evolution, ancient human species, new archaeological discoveries, and ancient history. And if that's the case, then I highly recommend you subscribe to my channel, click that bell icon to be notified whenever I upload, and if you enjoy my work, maybe consider becoming a patron or a channel member. It seems like Homophoresiansis wasn't the only enigmatic species found in Southeast Asia. There seems to be another species that lived in this area that is approximately equally as baffling to the archaeologists and anthropologists. Homophoresiansis was first discovered in 2003 on the island of Flores in Indonesia. I created a video about it going in depth on this species. Highly recommend watching. But only 4 years after the discovery of Homophoresiansis, the remains were discovered of a different species of ancient humans. Although at the time of this discovery, this really wasn't known. But before I go into the video, I would like to quickly mention that this video is kindly sponsored by Fabulous. Although, as per usual, more on the sponsor later in the video. My name is Kaylee, and in today's video, I'm going to tell you everything I found out about Homo Luzonensis, otherwise known as Callao Man or Ubag, as this species is locally called. So first, as per usual, if you've watched me for a while, you know that we're first going to take a look at the location of where the remains were found. The Callao Cave in which the remains were found is located in the northeast on the island of Luzon in the Philippines in Southeast Asia. So back in 2007, archaeologist Armand Salvador Mijares discovered a bone buried in the cave. After closer inspection, he and his colleagues figured out that it was a third metatarsal, or foot bone, from a species of human. Unknown which species at the time. So to figure out the age of the bone, they used uranium serious ablation, and they found out that this bone is approximately 67,000 years old, at the very least, which is the oldest discovered bone of an ancient human species in the Philippines, and among the oldest traces of humans in Southeast Asia, especially the particular region of the Philippines. So, we know from previous videos that I made, like the video I made on Homo Erectus, we know that ancient humans have ventured into Southeast Asia. We know this because there have been remains found and loads of evidence have been discovered that Homo Erectus made its way into Indonesia through land bridges. However, the island of Luzon in the Philippines has never been connected with a land bridge since more than 2.5 million years ago. And therefore, it was long believed that ancient humans hadn't ventured this far into the east. Somehow, these ancient humans changed their routine and they traveled further east, crossing the open ocean and reaching an isolated island a lot earlier in our history than we had thought possible. Well, speaking of routines and wanting to make changes, do you find it hard to adopt new routines that help you achieve goals faster and more efficiently? You can finally put your mind at ease and stop stressing out about being less focused and unproductive. With a digital coach like Fabulous, you will find the ideal routine and the difference in achieving your goals will be night and day. So Fabulous is a first habit tracking and motivational app that aims to help you make smart changes and build healthy habits. It was developed based on the research in behavioral science principles to develop great habits that will enable you to live the life that you want to live. So you can create your own rituals starting from when you first wake up to participating in challenges that will lead to big and long-lasting changes. You can start your beautiful journey between habit tracking by choosing one among hundreds of recommended habits. Or you can pick dedicated programs designed specifically for your own personal adventure over several weeks to help you achieve your goals. So don't wait any longer. start building your ideal daily routine, and the first 100 people who click on the link in the description down below will get 25% off a fabulous subscription. So back to the subject of today's video, the discovery of human remains on the island of Luzon in the Philippines dating back to 67,000 years ago. For a very long time, the story of human evolution in Asia seemed quite straightforward, but with the discovery of Homophoresiansis back in 2003, this all changed. And now that human remains have been found on the island of Luzon, dating back this long ago, the paleoanthropologists knew that the history of this region was far more complex than they had believed. A total of 13 specimens have been discovered, and these fossils have been investigated. And for a while, it was believed that the remains belonged to a Homo sapiens. But in 2019, it was revealed that these fossilized remains belonged to an entirely new species. A species now known as Homo Luzonensis. Named after the island of, you guessed it, Luzon. So the 13 discovered specimens are a thigh bone, two hand bones, 3 foot bones and 7 teeth. And these remains belong to at least 2 different adults and 1 child. The oldest discovered fossil is 67,000 years old, while the youngest discovered fossil dates to 50,000 years ago. This actually shows that Homo Luzonensis lived at the same time as many other ancient human species, like the Neanderthals, the Denisovans, Homophoresiansis, and Homo sapiens. And the reason that it was recognized as a new species and not just a Homophoresiansis 2.0 is because of the fact that the remains that were discovered had features that were similar to the species in the Australopithecus genus. Although that is the same as with Homophoresiansis, we had that as well. But what's funny is that Homo Luzonensis has a lot in common in its mosaic of a morphology with Homophoresiansis, although they are considered to be 2 different species. So a lot of the characteristics in the morphology of Homo Luzonensis are similar to the Australopithecines and early Homo species like Homo Erectus and Homo habilis, and not as many similarities with modern humans or more recent Homo species like the Neanderthals and the Denisovans. So to give an example, for instance, the premolars of Homo Luzonensis have many characteristics that are similar to the premolars of Australopithecines, Homo erectus, and Homo habilis, while the small molars are similar to those found in us, Homo sapiens, modern humans. Homo Luzonensis actually has curved toes and finger bones, and that does actually suggest that Homo Luzonensis was quite skilled and even adept at climbing trees, as well as walking upright on the ground for long distances. They were able to do both very well. So, to quickly mention, because I would like to preface this, no one is suggesting that they evolved backwards, back to climbing trees, but their origins and the fact that they were isolated on an island for a very long time might actually have resulted in them becoming skilled climbers. We also know that Homo Luzonensis was a small species, just like Homophoresiansis, although even smaller than Homophoresiansis. Although we cannot really know for sure what they actually looked like from the fossils that have been discovered so far, we don't have enough to figure any of that out. What we do know is that they average a height of approximately 1.2 meters, which is very small. And that's approximately 4 feet for my American viewers. This actually makes them the second human dwarf species that we have discovered so far. The first, as I mentioned a few times now, Homophoresiansis. So it seems like the discovery of Homophoresiansis and Homo Luzonensis flips the script of the human evolutionary timeline. These two species are absolutely challenging the idea that human evolution slowly progressed over time from less advanced into more advanced species. Yeah, it's weird. they show that evolution went a different route, or that their origins lie in pre-human lineages, like the Australopithecines, maybe? I don't know. Maybe because they are descendant from Homo erectus but got isolated this long ago that their entire morphology changed? We don't know. What's most puzzling is the fact that this species lived on the island of Luzon, which has been an island for over 2.6 million years without a land bridge. And to get to this island, they had to cross a very large stretch of open ocean, which definitely wasn't an easy feat to accomplish. The oldest evidence of humans being present on the island of Luzon dates back to approximately 700,000 years ago. Archaeologists have discovered evidence of butchery that suggests that Homo erectus individuals may have reached the island as early as 700,000 years ago, which is mind-boggling because, again, they would have had to cross a large stretch of open ocean 700,000 years ago. Unfortunately, the scientists were not able to extract any DNA from the remains that were uncovered. This, of course, has to do with the climate in which the remains were discovered. As I've mentioned a few times on this channel, when it's too humid and too warm, DNA just simply cannot be preserved. It degrades and it's gone forever. Just poof. Sorry. So all species in the Homo genus are our evolutionary cousins and ancestors and brother and sister species. But some of them are quite perplexing the paleoanthropologists. So as I have mentioned a few times now, paleoanthropologists don't like to define remains as a new species, as they are skeptical of doing this when the number of specimen isn't very high. The reason for this is actually very simple. It's very hard to determine if it's just an outlier in an already known species, or if it's a complete new species when your sample size is very small. Could have been a mutation, could have been an individual with a disease, we don't know. But even though there weren't many fossilized remains from Homo luzonensis, it was quite evident that they do not belong to any of the other species, and therefore the anthropologists felt like it was compelling enough to place them in a species of their own. Anthropologists, however, do agree upon one major thing, and that is that we need to excavate and focus on more areas than just Africa and Europe. Who knows how many surprising remains we can discover in other areas of the world that baffle our current understanding. Maybe we will be able to discover one or maybe even more of the ghost species that we know have existed, because it's factually proven that they have existed because we can find them within our modern DNA. There are ghost species that we currently haven't identified, but we know they have existed. The human evolutionary timeline is absolutely not a straight line, and it covers the entire globe, so we should look accordingly. Change our focus into new areas and try to find the missing puzzle pieces if we want to broaden our understanding for future generations. It's not just for us, but it's also for future generations that we need to uncover where we come from. Like, where exactly do we come from? What's the exact evolutionary timeline? It may take like a few hundred years before we actually be able to do that, but still. Before I end the video, however, I would like to remind you of the fabulous deal. Start building your ideal daily routine, and the first 100 people who click on the link in the description down below will get a 25% off a fabulous subscription. So go ahead and click. Thank you. If you enjoyed watching, then don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you'd like to see more of these kind of videos, and click that bell icon if you want to be notified whenever I upload. If you haven't seen my previous videos yet, then don't make me cry in a corner. Click the card in the upper right corner. Thank you. I said corner twice now. Or click a video in the description down below, or a video in the end card, whatever. I cater to you. YouTube caters to you. It has suggested for viewer. I'm very smart like that. I would also like to say a massive thank you to all my patrons and my channel members. Thank you so much for supporting me. It's absolutely amazing that you want to do that. And if you are considering supporting me, then maybe become a patron or channel member. And yeah, this was Homo Luzonensis. There's not much known, but I will look into Asia and the entire region and the species more in the future. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye.